it's happening so fast that you just, you know, say what you can and you kind of get out, because it's just like, you know, you have this, you have these 3 minutes or 4 minutes or what, 2 minutes, whatever, to talk about it, but you don't have, you know, it's like, you know, you can't, you just can't dwell on anything during that, or maybe you can just dwell on one thing and that's all that there is, that there's a lot of things happening, but there's just that one little detail that you just have to, like, magnify, because that's like maybe the, you know, maybe the girl drinking wine in the corner or something, when there's like maybe somebody getting stabbed in the other room, but the other room doesn't matter because there's this girl just drinking wine in the corner that's like totally oblivious to everything.
Erogeny is kind of, it's like another thing, when I was like six or something and my cousin Elaine dressed me up in her clothes and I ran, you know, I went home after she did it to show my parents, and my dad just freaked out. He was like, he just totally freaked out. I was wondering what the big deal was. And then, you know, I realized it was wrong.
But I think these foxes have been dead for a long time. They led a really long, healthy life. And then, you know, after they've been dead for like 30 minutes, they're made into a
right.
So Peter shouldn't get upset about that.
Oh, yeah, here at the end, it's about kind of endings and beginnings and just when you think, like, sometimes the final end, like a death or whatever, is just actually a beginning instead of really an ending. Trent's like the one, Trent, the rhythm guitar player, is like the one who makes a lot of the arrangements and is kind of the glue that holds the whole thing together. And he's just a real kind of keeps everyone kind of happy or whatever, where he keeps everyone talking to each other. So back to Mark, he's kind of the quiet one who, if you don't know him, he doesn't really say a whole lot. He just kind of nods his head every once in a while. Kevin is definitely has his ideas. He has an opinion for everything, and he will definitely let you know. He's very outspoken. Especially if he's been drinking a little bit, he isn't afraid to say what he thinks. You know.
$10 a day, I'll do that for the rest of my life.
Yeah. And Aaron is just kind of goes with the flow. He's just like, that's cool. You know, that's about all he ever says is, that's cool. Aaron, I'm gonna kill you. That's cool. So, Aaron, it's really hard to get Aaron very upset unless you take his lighter and start lighting it a bunch. It's like one of those Zippos, and that really pisses him off. If you take his lighter and you just start lighting it and letting the flame burn, that's the way to see Aaron's rage.
Get a shot of how good of a cigarette roller I am. That is so fucking cool.
But her name was Catherine Mansfield, and she wrote about this lady who threw parties, and now I don't even remember the story that well, but her whole life revolved around throwing dinner parties, and I just kind of put my own interpretation to it, I changed it from like a socialite throwing dinner parties to like one of the beautiful people in a college crowd throwing dinner parties.